Hey guys, welcome back to Harmon Homestead. Okay, we've picked up in subscribers lately. We've picked up in videos. This is a chicken scratch talk time here. Okay, I've noticed all of our videos, it seems like everybody likes the DIY stuff. For some reason, the quail, and that was just a cute little video on our quail. And the gardening and buckets or whatever else. So this whole talk time, since we're learners too, and we're beginners too, 2 years into this, a couple of years into this, I want to know what you think. This is all questions to you. I'm not going to tell you that much. I want to know what you're thinking. So that's why I'm going to call this talk to me. Okay. I want to talk to you. And I want you to talk to me. That's the main thing. Because, guys, the only reason, if I don't lose this pen, the only reason that I started this was to encourage others to homestead, okay? And I wanted to educate somebody on how to become more sustainable. I've told you before, I'm 29. I'm about to be 30. My husband is in his 30s. We are oddballs. No one does this that we know. I know there's people that homestead, but no one around here that's our age, okay? We have no one to talk to. I want to get this community going, and I want to help you the best way I can. That is the only reason I'm doing this. Because if one guy or one gal can get out to the country and do what their grandparents did or what their great-grandparents did and preserve it and, you know, have fellowship with us about that, then guys, that's what I'm after. That's what I'm after. And if you have any questions along the way, maybe I, with 2 years of little experience, can help you some way or another. Okay. This is from me to you. That's the only reason I'm doing this. That's why I started the buckets. You need to research all this. It's just something that I thought of because my husband said, no, I'm not putting in another raised bed. You've already got two gardens. Well, I was going to grow these beans and everything else, and I was going to find a way. And so I started thinking, hey, somebody disabled could go do this. Somebody that doesn't have a truck or a trailer to haul home lumber to do a raised bed, they could go do this. Anybody could go get a bucket. You know, you need to make sure it's food safe. You need to make sure all this other stuff. You don't even need a drill to put drainage holes in it. You could use a screwdriver and poke a hole in the bottom. Guys, that's for a temporary fix or somebody that wants to experiment and learn. And apparently it's picked up huge, and I appreciate every single video, but I don't want all my videos on that, especially now because my husband did break down and build me another raised bed. So I'm going to use that, okay, because that is better. All right, so talk to me. I wrote down a few topics. No, I cannot sit here and talk to you and remember all this. I cannot. So many things race through my mind, okay? I will answer every comment on this video. Any way that I can help. That's all I'm doing is trying to help somebody, okay? Or if they just want to talk. I want to grow this community of homesteading, especially if you are younger. You're not alone. There's other people out there just like you that's struggling and messing up and learning the same way as you. And there's other people that feel deep down, hey, I wish someone else would do this, and I wish I had something in common with some of these people. I work full time, okay? I'm busy. I do all this. And I can relate to a lot of people out there, okay? Young, old, indifferent. But I especially want to spark this younger population, okay? I don't have enough subscribers, I think, to do a live stream, although we're jumping. I quit doing this YouTube for a while. I said, well, there's only a few, you know, I just don't know. I was embarrassed. I don't know if people are going to laugh at me or talk, you know. And then I just finally got past it, and I said, no, I'm out on a mission, and it is to preserve homesteading, whatever you want to call it, preserve self-reliance and preserve the past. Okay, I've done these old-fashioned videos. That's our first topic, old-fashioned things. Does that help any of you? Does that bring back any memories for you? old-fashioned things you don't see all the time. Rocking chairs, sitting around playing music, okay? Playing music that a lot of people now don't do. Playing a musical instrument, reading off paper, okay? Having books, oil lamps. There's so many things I could go on. Do you want more of that? If you do, let me know. It's what I grew up with, and I'm a sentimentalist at heart. I like to keep that going. And if I'm ever blessed enough to have a child, I'd like them to know. And seeing as how we don't have any children, I feel like y'all are kind of my children, even though you're probably older than me. So I want to keep it going, keep it sparked up. It's a good thing, and this stuff it's all becoming relics now, and no one's doing it, and it's going to fade away. That's like classic cars. You don't see those anymore. And everybody wanted to revive those and wanted to bring back those body styles, but still, they're just never going to be built that way, and they're never going to look that way again, okay? So, do you like to keep it going? Do you like the old-fashioned stuff, okay? Chickens. I've done chicken videos. That's been probably the least amount of views I've had. Guys, that's how I got started, was watching all these people talk about chickens. I had to go to YouTube and other sources to see what to do because I didn't know. And I got a passel of chickens and for my birthday a couple years ago, and I wanted to start having baby chicks. Everybody does. Started buying them, you know, at the local feed store, and then went on from there. And then we got into incubators and all that. I'm not going to keep talking about it if it's not helping somebody. If it's helping somebody, let me know, okay? Talk to me. What animals do you have on your homestead? Within a month, I am hoping to have some ducks. I've never had ducks before. I know not one clue about ducks except what I've researched. We have quail. I can tell you right here, even though I hate to say this, even though it's one of the top videos, I don't care for the quail. I just don't. That's not for me. That's really for my husband. He likes them. It's a partnership, so whatever. But I don't know if we're going to be in the quail much longer. Rabbits. I would like to get into meat rabbits, okay? We do not have the space for anything much bigger than goats. Just a few goats. My husband knows about cattle. I do not. So this is, you know, it depends on what you have and where you're at and blah, 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 and what you can afford. And now we have bought like a local pig. We've had that as far as meat and all that's been sold to us. That we enjoyed. Deer meat. If my husband, you know, kills a deer, we eat that. I have not bought meat at the store in a long, long time between the pig and the deer. What have you got? What have you got? What would you like to get on your homestead for animals? Our next thing is ducks, and I'm hoping maybe the rabbits won't be too much longer. So we got chickens, hopefully ducks, okay? Gardening. What's your best crops? What's your best plants? What do you like to plant? What is your worst plants? What do you just cannot get to grow no matter what? Maybe I can help you. Maybe that's what I can grow, but I can't grow something else, and maybe you could show me how. You know, talk to me. Talk to me, guys. What would you like to try? For example, I tried scarlet runner beans last year, and I tried those in buckets. Well, they were beautiful, and I wanted them for the beautiful blooms, but they didn't make many beans. They grew everywhere. They tangled up. It was humongous. Well, then I start looking, and they're more ornamental than for food production. Talk to me, okay? It's tidbits like that I can talk about, but I want you guys to navigate me here, okay? I want you to tell me. Tell me. What's been your best plants for food production? Ours, hands down, green beans. Pole beans, snap beans, bush beans, whatever. What has not been that worth it? Cowpeas. It'll produce, but it takes so many to make even a side for a meal by the time you shell those out. It's just not worth it to me. You would have to have a whole ton. So, talk to me, okay? What have you had trouble with seed starting? What seedlings do you have trouble with? And what always seems to do great? My number one, kale. Kale will grow. the lettuce, you start getting leggy. It's certain plants, no matter what you do, you can get these grow lights, you can get a greenhouse, you can do whatever. Certain things have more trouble than others, okay? Tell me what you've experienced. With food preservation, do you like the canning stuff? We can talk about that. Last year I just started canning, but we had great success. Now, I did get an electric pressure canner. A child could do it. I mean, it was so easy and so wonderful. However, you can freeze your food too. It just depends. What do you do? Do you like to freeze? Do you like to can? Talk to me here. Do you like more in-ground gardening, or do you like the raised beds, or do you like the planters? You know, why are you wanting the planters? I'm telling you, I didn't have an option if I wanted to grow some of this stuff, like the scarlet runner beans. I had to go out and, you know, it's like, you know, the buckets just popped up. My husband just had to deal with it. So I found if there's a will, there's a way. And he learned quick, like, hey, well, this little gal is serious now. She's going to grow something somewhere, somehow. That's how all that came to be. What do you grow in? Are you into hydroponics? We have just started that, and I'm digging it. I'm digging it so far. We're going to look at maybe even getting into another one. That's something else. If you do hydroponics, do you do a portable unit inside? Do you do a unit outside? Are you into this big stuff, big tank units? Or who would have thought Swiss chard would have done better in it than lettuce, really, from what we've tried? Or what types of lettuce have you tried, if you're even trying it? What are you growing this year? And what are you wanting to grow, and what will you never grow again? What are your goals for this year? What do you want to do? And tell me this. Why are you wanting to homestead? I love country life. That's me, and that's what I like. But why are you wanting to do it? I just want to get a kind of an assessment of what we've got here, and whatever I can do, tell me. Do you like crafts? Do you like projects? What do you do? I'm so curious as to all of this. And a lot of these channels, they sit and they tell you stuff, and that's what I've been doing. But I care about the audience, and I want to know. I want to know. Any way I can help, that's what I'm here to do. So talk to me. Anything you want to talk to me about, feel free to comment as far as, you know, homesteading related. And, my husband and I will try to answer you the best we can, and we will read every comment. We appreciate it all, but I just really want you to talk to me. I'd like to get an assessment of where we're at and where we're going, and that's really all I can talk to you about is gardening and animals and food preservation, because that's all I can do. I can't go out and make soap. I don't know how. You might could do that. This, you know, if I ever decide to pick it up, you'll be the first one to know. Okay. The ducks will carry you through that journey. I'm just knock on wood. I got a wooden lamp right there. Knock on wood. I hope I get those for my birthday. Cause the reason I'm wanting ducks is this is what you have to look at, guys. There's not many people in our area that has these. So if you know, duck eggs are known for bacon. Everybody loves those rich duck eggs. If you have ducklings, okay, that could be a hot commodity if people wanted those. Do you live in an area where people even want ducks? You have to really think about this, and we've really thought about it, but you have to look into why you're wanting it. Something, I'm going to tell you, we've got silky chickens, okay? I wanted those silkies. Everybody wanted them. Most men I've talked to cannot stand them. Most women love them. Opposite with a quail. Men love the quail. It's just something about those quail, and the women don't really, you know, that's from what I've talked to. Everybody has their own, they kind of veer what they like. If everybody wants to pick up on a fad, okay? When I joined all these chicken groups and how to, you know, even local groups, everybody wanted these silkies. Well, I thought, well, I'll try to do these silkies, you know, too, and maybe I can get into it. Well, then everything gets flooded, okay? So many people have those. you, so whatever you choose, you're going to have to, I would say, get something basic, get something a little off the wall. It may help you, okay? And I would get something that I would know, I knew that I'd be happy with keeping, okay? Don't do it for a fad, because it's going to go out the window. The good thing is, not many people around us, like I said, have these ducks. So that can hurt you if you don't know what you're doing, but it can help you if you ever want to grow and expand with that, okay? That's really all I've got to say, guys. I want you to talk to me. I can't answer every question on how to do this stuff. I mainly just want you to talk to me, okay? And I just want to find out why you're homesteading, what you're growing, all about it, the animals. Comment below and we will answer you back. We'll see you next time. Hey, and keep it up. Be sustainable, guys. Every day counts. Every time you go out and do something, it's wisdom and knowledge. And even if you fail, well, let me tell you something. You can pick right back up and do something again or do it different. Keep going. We'll see you next time on Harmon Homestead.